Hey yo, we're doing the most on the most, episode one. My name is Chama.
Hi, my name is Tia.
Move, girls, your boy Chris.
Wow.
Up in the building. Doing the most.
No, you're doing
yeah.
too much.
You're
doing that's way, you're doing. Way too much. Mm. But that's okay, Chris. Do you, be you. We're not necessarily here for it, but we'll endure through the episode. Today's episode, we will be discussing social media and the need for validation. So stay tuned, get your popcorn, drink some water, make a cup of tea because we won't be serving any. And
I'm not getting into this.
Well, before time, in the beginning,
platforms were created. Chris is such a loser. But anyway, platforms were created to enable users to share content and participate in each other's special moments. Thus, social media was created. Now, Generation Z won't know what was there before Facebook because obviously they're too young and they just, for them, it just started there. But there's a whole history behind it. I think those of us that are older can remember. Mm. You guys, anything?
MySpace.
High five.
Friendstar.
Sure.
Be quick.
Wow. All right. You got me there.
Mm. So, like, even before that, like, way before all of that, there was the first one, which was called 6 Degrees of Separation. So, we've come a long way, I think, in how we communicate and how we share our posts and how we view things online. And shout out to Twitter, Facebook, Instagram for allowing us to even have this conversation. So, let's do it.
Mm-hmm. Let's do it.
Yo, what happened to Snapchat, though?
It died.
It's too very relevant.
They updated
though.
That time, that one time, and then I just wait. Couldn't do it
was
anymore.
It? Did it die the moment? Is it Kylie Jenner said that?
Kylie.
Oh, Kylie.
Pop offices.
Yeah, I don't watch Keep It Up with the Kardashians. I'm sorry. Yeah, Kylie Jenner was saying that she hated the site, the app and everything. And
it was around that time, so they updated it. I mean, Snapchat is still relevant. I won't lie, but they updated it, and then everything went out the window, and then we started getting the instant updates. Oh, what was it? The timed updates. What do you call it? The disappearing statuses.
The IG.
On WhatsApp. Oh. On IG and everything. Oh, and then okay. people.
And Facebook has that too.
Yeah,
so.
Facebook has that too.
All right.
So, all right. So, moving on. Let's dive into it. Yeah.
All right. So, what are the trends and the various platforms that you guys use and know about?
Interesting. I saw something really interesting. I sound like I'm about to...
Do tell,
My
do
name
tell.
Is Chama and I'm about to... Anyway, I saw this really interesting picture on social media and it basically breaks down 7 social media platforms into the 7 deadly sins. And I'll just go ahead and name them. For pride, we have Instagram. For envy, we have Facebook. For sloth, we have Netflix. Wrath, we have Twitter. Uh-huh. Yeah, I agree. Greed, we have LinkedIn. Last, we have Tinder. And last but not the least, gluttony, Yelp. If you guys don't know what Yelp is, it's a review site. Basically, it's a review site, I think.
Yeah, basically.
I don't know how that ties into gluttony, but moving on. Yeah? Mm-hmm.
So, which platforms do you guys use the most? First and foremost, yeah, which ones do you use the most? And then do you agree with which one that falls under?
I use Instagram the most. And it falls under pride. I do use Instagram the most. And I think Instagram is a mix of pride and envy because it's a lot of... It's like a stuck-up Facebook, if you know what I mean, yeah?
Yeah.
Look at
it's
me!
Like, it's like a Facebook that went to private school or something.
Precisely. Mm. Just like that. I use Instagram the most and I also use Twitter. Wrath. That I agree. 100.
Yeah, I usually use Facebook the most, but I really don't agree with it. Like, I don't envy anything on that platform that I actually look at. Usually when I go on Facebook, I usually post my personal stuff. So I really don't look out for other people and see what they're doing and say, oh, I wish I was doing that. So
Maybe a strong-willed, bruh.
Probably, but yeah, that's me. So for me, it's Facebook. What about you, Tia? What you going with?
I am going with Netflix because it's very fitting for my lifestyle. Yes.
And you obviously you agree with
the sloth. Yeah, it's really, you do become quite a sloth whilst you're in that zone. And then I frequently use Twitter. But of late, it is wrath because people are always in a tour of sorts and like they are angry. So, it's an interesting time to be alive. So what do you guys think validation is?
I think in simple terms, validation is just seeking approval.
Okay, so which platform do you think people do that the most on?
I think Facebook and Instagram the most. Twitter, not that much, but then it is moving towards that validation thing. You see more people posting. I have nothing against nudes, but you see more people posting nudes. I have nothing against nudes. So I think that's where people seek the most validation, Instagram and Facebook, and now more increasingly Twitter.
Yeah, I agree with that. For me, I think Instagram is like the hub of validation where people always just want to get followers. Like Facebook, I don't think many people look out for that because it doesn't show you how many people are following you or how many people you're following. It just shows that you've got friends unless you check, you know, deep down in those the settings and stuff. Be woke. Anyway, that's what I think. I just think Facebook is the least, but Instagram is the most because it has that. It's just as much as Twitter.
So. I don't know. I feel like Facebook has that pick me, look at me type vibe going on because everyone's always like highlighting their best moments in life, which is fair. I mean, do that. But then like, can we have a realistic general view? Like, okay, sometimes you go through things and that's fine too. Like, I feel like the world needs to stop.
Yeah.
I'm looking at you some type of way because who's going to post, no, today I only have water in the fridge?
I mean, people do that on Twitter though.
Yeah.
But no, they do it for comic relief. They just want to, like a meme. They'll try to create a trend. So they don't really do it to show that this is my current status. They'll just make it seem like, oh, look at me. Haha, this is funny. I've only got water in the fridge. So I think it goes both ways.
Yeah, this is true. And I think the thing about Twitter and Instagram, it has more to do with it being a popularity contest. It's about the number of followers that you have. And then Facebook is, you know, it's limited. You have 5,000 friends and it's more of a, look at me, envy me, you know, be jealous. I've graduated. Yeah, so I think that's what it is. People are actually getting paid on Instagram and on Twitter by the number of followers that they have.
Damn,
this is why you see, Chris, really?
Nobody's following you like that.
This is why you see people are actually making a living out of being Instagram celebrities or Twitter celebrities, yeah?
Yeah, I agree.
Mm-hmm. So the follow button on Facebook?
That's an automatic follow button that you can use in the event that, okay, so let's say I'm friends with you on Facebook, yeah? If I don't want to see your content for some reason, you just post nonsense, I can unfollow you and your stuff won't pop up on my newsfeed at all. And also when you reach that limit of 5,000 friends, all you can do with that profile is just follow. That's it. Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah.
I get that.
Mm-hmm.
So have virtual relationships become more important than real life ones?
It actually has, because when was the last time you actually saw people interact in real life? Like someone would actually meet a stranger in the street, or not in the street, like let's just say you go to an eating place, shout out Hungry Lion, and then you meet a girl that you like, and then you approach her, you talk to her, you sit down, you get her number, then you start texting. When was the last time you saw something like that happen?
This is why we're seeing an up, whatever, people are now, an increase of online dating websites, because it's easier to approach someone online. This is why people are sliding in each other's DMs. Online relationships have become more important than real life relationships. It's easier. People have more courage to approach each other online. And Twitter now has, you know, people, not now actually, people are forming cliques on Twitter where people, you know, agree with each other. They hold the same opinions on Twitter and then they decide to meet up in real life and then they become friends in real life, just off of social media.
Chama, a question. Do you think, I was hearing what you said about how online dating has actually rapidly increased, mm-hmm. like in terms of online dating sites and whatnot.
Mm-hmm.
Do you feel like, despite the pervs and all these like guys on online that use that site for whatever, God knows what, but mm-hmm. do you think that those dating websites were made for a benefit of those that have got low self-esteem issues?
Yes, it is. It is for the benefit of people that, you know, some people are introverts. Yeah, you're not. Mm. You don't go out. You don't go to the club where people meet. People meet in the club. People meet at church. If you don't go to those places, you can easily download Tinder and decide to get your hookups from there, because that's what I think Tinder is. It's a hookup site. That's what it is. Argue if you want, but it's a hookup site. But yeah, social media has given the courage to people to approach, you know, people that you wouldn't normally, sometimes people that you wouldn't normally approach in real life. Yeah?
Yeah. I agree. I think it's created a culture that allows us to interact more online than we do with each other in real time. Okay, so where do we see social media going? Like, what's the direction you see it going?
I saw this one Black Mirror episode where, damn it, Tia, you're twerking in the middle of my answer. Like, relax, baby girl. I saw a Black Mirror episode where social media became currency, yeah? And what that means basically is how popular you are on social media decided where you lived, where you could eat, who you hang out with, what events you were invited to, what job you could get. And I think that's the direction that it's going to go in. People are going to be saying, you can't come to my party. You don't have 5,000 followers. Oh, you can't come to this event. Only come to this event. You can only get the tickets if you have 10,000 followers. You know what I mean?
In that case, I would be totally screwed. Like, I would be low end middle.
I would
be like the janitor because I don't have the likes.
Yeah, so I agree with Chama because I feel it's going to head in the direction where most people seek validation and social acceptance in order for them to do certain things that they probably would want to do, like maybe join cliques or just socialize with people online. It would just be that platform that will lose its significance, what it was meant to, what it was built for.
Which it was built for connecting, and now people are using it to show off to each other, and you know, it's actually stunning as a habit. Hey, moving on. Hey, people are getting triggered. People are getting Chris, come back, bring it back. People are getting triggered by the things that they see on social media, not knowing that what they see. I'm only going to put what I want Tia and Chris to see. I'm not going to put me suffering. I'm not going to put, I've got one slice of bread left on social media. So that is triggering a lot of mental health issues in the people that are seeing this stuff, because they will look at this person they've bought a new car, and then they'll say, why don't I have a Range Rover? You know, why don't I have this and why don't I have that? Not knowing that in real life, this person has been eating noodles from 1st to the 30th to get that car to show you on social media that they're doing all right.
Okay, I want to look at positives. I'm a glass half full person. I want to think, what good is there in society? Let's discuss that. Wow. What are the pros of having social media?
I feel one of the pros that I can actually point out is like, if you're stakes for like, how can I put this? Entertainment, right? Most people actually get a kick out of social media in the sense that they find the things they like, they find the things like their favorite comedians post stuff, the memes and whatnot. And it actually does help pass the time, especially when you're stressed out at work, or maybe you're just at home and you're bored, or maybe you're like a girl and text you back. You know what I'm saying? Just say, guy, you know, I'm just going on Facebook right now and just look at a meme real quick. Yeah. So I think one of the pros is, it's entertainment basically.
Yeah, they call social media the bored at work network. So you could sit, if you've got a project and you don't want to get to it. If you're like me, I procrastinate a lot. I don't get nothing done. So sometimes I'd rather scroll through my Instagram feed and see what's popping, see what's happening. And maybe that will motivate me to do my work. And also, it has, let's not ignore, social media has made it easy for businesses to advertise. First of all, easy, convenient, cheap, effective, and quantifiable. Advertise on social media.
Hey, Chama is woke.
And it actually has a wide reach, yeah. It's a huge coverage.
And it's a reach that you can measure because social media will give you results. If you post an ad on Facebook, you see how many people have seen that ad, how many people have actually clicked on your Facebook page because of that ad, et cetera, et cetera.
Tell them, girl.
Right. And it also created jobs like social media influencers who now get paid to be creative online. Yeah, so shout out to them.
Shout out to the creatives.
I hope they're paying you well.
Wow.
Alright, moving right along. How do you think it's impacted how we interact with each other here in Zambia?
People have become so mean on social media. People have become so mean, and because you can be a keyboard warrior, if I post something and you don't agree with it, instead of you just scrolling past, you want to come and say, hey, but you're trash, or you ain't ish, or et cetera, et cetera. People have become really mean on social media, and we've lost that spirit of Ubuntu, that spirit of togetherness. We just want to attack each other and throw jabs and, you know, troll each other, et cetera, et cetera. I don't think that's healthy, y'all. It's become a toxic environment.
Yeah. It's terrible, guys. Like, can't even function right now, like, just thinking about it, you know. All the trolls, all the cyberbullying, all the subs.
Really?
No, but yeah, it has actually impacted the way we interact here in Zambia quite negatively, because all you would see, if it's not someone trash talking, maybe someone else's, like, fashion label, or maybe it looks like a fashion week, it's someone else that's probably just subbing someone else based on maybe they owe the money, whatever. But there's no unity, as Chama said. There's just a bit of division, so it's kind of crazy.
Okay, so, like, what would you like to see change?
I'd like to see people be nicer to each other. You know, if someone posts, let's say I have a business, I'm running a business, I'm selling Androids. If you're an iPhone person, don't come and say that S7 Edge is whack because you like iPhones and so you must laugh at the Android that I'm selling. You know what I mean? You should understand that people have preferences, and let's not, you know, be mean to each other based on each other's preferences. If someone advertises something, don't go and laugh in the comments and tag Tia, like, ha ha ha, Tia, come and see, which is popular in Zambia. And also, you know, let's stop cyberbullying each other. People are using social media to cyberbully each other. They take real life situations, post them on social media to bully each other. We have situations where someone would take a video. You know, let's not underestimate the power of social media. Things go viral easily. So someone will take a video of me maybe twerking in the club and they don't think I twerk really good. So they'll post it on social media so that the whole world can laugh at me. Why are we doing that? Yeah, why are we doing that?
But you don't, though.
That's not the point, though. That's not the point.
No, but she has a point. She has a point. She's actually touched on everything that I was going to say. You know, let's promote each other rather than just divide each other. It's just a waste for someone to belittle other people just because they feel they're doing better. That whole illusion of them doing good, I don't think it's necessary.
All an illusion. You guys are just lying to us. You're not that happy. You can't be that happy in your relationship. You can't be that happy in your relationship, fam. You've got problems. You're so fight. You should be posting your fights.
What? Wait, what?
Hey, if you're that happy, be happy. Don't let Chama tell you that you can't be that happy.
Sat, you're not that happy.
All right. So how do you guys think that we can bring that about in our society right now?
I think since, like, sensitizing people, telling them what, telling them, like, the do's and don'ts, like, just educate them. I feel like just targeting people that really aren't aware that the impact that they have on others on social media actually affects them negatively, like, bad. So I think people need to be, aware of this. There should be some awareness to it. And that way to reach a lot of people, and they'll be able to look at it more closely and carefully.
I think also Generation Z, the younger generation, social media is such a big part of their lives. I think this is something that should be brought up in schools. They should have, yes. we have sexual education, yeah? Mm. So they should have social media etiquette classes where you learn how to treat each other on social media. And I think more people should be brought to the book for cyberbullying. I think you shouldn't get away with calling people names and making someone fall into depression. You should be brought to the book.
Yeah. Okay, so basically, guys, be in touch with your humanity as you type, tweet, and do whatever it is that you do online. And, thank you for listening, Cassius.
Remember, it's not just social media. It's a real-life person behind that tweet that you're laughing at, et cetera, et cetera.
You know, I feel like some sad music should have been playing in the back when you were saying all that.
I like this word, et cetera, et cetera.
Right. Catch us next episode as we discuss many other things.
And you can find us on Twitter at @themost_podcast. On Facebook, we are The Most Podcast. And yeah.
We do not have an Instagram page. We're not cool enough yet.
Yeah, Instagram's for the cool people.
But thank you for listening and catch us next time.
Bye.
It's a wrap.
It's a wrap. Hey.
Hey. Bring the beat back.
I'm out.
Mic drop.
Hi, guys. I hope you had fun listening to the episode. We had so much fun recording our very first episode, and we're looking forward to more episodes. Please feel free to contact us on Twitter @themost_podcast and on Facebook, The Most Podcast. Ask us your questions, give us your suggestions for episodes. Until next time, peace.